students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jyoti and you are watching JG Chemistry. So students, today we are going to solve the problems based on UV spectroscopy. This is the part 2. We have done in part 1 electronic transition problems and oxochrome and chromophore problems. In this part 2, we will be solving the problem based on the solvent polarity and the effect of it on the wavelength of absorption. Let's begin. So we'll understand this concept by using this problem where they are asking the N to pi star bend of mesityl oxide appears at 335 nanometer in cyclohexane and moves to 320 nanometer in ethanol. So you can see, you can notice one thing here, 335 nanometer to 320 nanometer. So if you notice, the wavelength is reducing here, right? So the wavelength reduce means hypsochromic shift. Now if you notice this, the solvent cyclohexane is a non-polar solvent while ethanol is a polar solvent. So if you conclude one statement that on increasing the polarity of solvent, the wavelength of absorption for N to pi star transition decreases, right? So that is the hypsochromic shift. So they are asking why. So we'll understand this by using this energy level diagram. First thing which is very important, this solvent polarity effects occurs for the molecule which bears the carbonyl group. Okay, if the molecule doesn't have the carbonyl group and it has only the C double bond C, the solvent polarity will not show any effect. So this is important. Your molecule, the given molecule, should have the carbonyl compound, okay, carbonyl functional group. So as you can see, the mesityl oxide, the structure is mentioned here and it has a, it is a alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl group. So it has the carbonyl here. Therefore, we can assume N to pi and pi to pi, both the transitions are possible here. Okay, so now effect of solvent. So first energy level diagram where we have seen, as I told you, that there are two possible transition. One is pi to pi star transition, other is N to pi star transition, which is visible in the near UV region. Okay, it has sigma, pi and all the electrons. So all possible transitions will be there, but these two transition you can see in near UV. So pi to pi, N to pi. So this is in the presence of non-polar solvent. Now what is the effect if you increase the polarity of the solvent? So what happens here, as you can notice here, the antibonding, which is the excited state pi orbital, we have drawn here slightly less. Why it is so? Because the antibonding, the excited pi star orbital, stabilizes in the presence of polar solvent in the excited state. And so how it is stabilizes? Because of the hydrogen bonding between the carbonyl of the molecule and the solvent, polar solvent, like here in this case ethanol. Okay, so there is a hydrogen bonding between the ethanol and the carbonyl oxygen, which stabilizes the excited state of the pi orbital, and so the energy of this orbital decreases compared to the non-polar solvent. Okay, so since the excited state is stabilized, the energy is decreased, and so if the energy is decreased, the wavelength of absorption will increase. As we know, the energy is inversely proportional to the wavelength. So the same statement we have written for pi to pi star transition, as the polarity of the solvent increases, it for K band, which is for pi to pi star transition, undergoes bathochromic shift, or you can say red shift. That means the wavelength increases. Okay, now we will see the effect of polarity of solvent on N to pi star transition. Now you can notice here, again, this N, which is the non-bonding orbital, is stabilized in the ground state. Therefore, you can notice the energy of this ground state and non-bonding orbital is decreased. Why? Because the two electron in the ground state of non-bonding is more stable, right? So, as compared to the excited state with one electron of non-bonding. So, since the two electron of the non-bonding is stabilized in the ground state, again with the help of hydrogen bonding, okay, so hydrogen bonding between the polar solvent and the carbon group stabilizes the ground state of N orbital, Therefore, the energy of an orbital decreases. You can compare, the energy decreases. So ultimately, the distance between n to pi star increases. The distance increases means the energy gap increases, means the wavelength of absorption decreases, right? E increases, wavelength decreases, inversely proportional. So we can say for n to pi star transition, which is called R band, radical band undergoes hypsochromic shift. You can also call blue shift, means wavelength decreases. So this is the justification of our question for why n to pi star of mesityl oxide appears at 335 nanometer in cyclohexane. This 335 nanometer, but it moves to 320 nanometer, means here in ethanol, because the energy gap increases, so wavelength decreases. That's the justification and the effect of polarity of solvent on the n to pi and pi to pi star transition. Okay, so reason, the same which I have explained, is mentioned here. So you can note it down for your justification, for your final answer which you are going to write in your, if you are a MSc student, you have to write the justification, you have to mention the diagram, draw the diagram along with the justification. Those who are appearing in any competition, so for them also you can just find out this relation. It is very important, write in this format so that you can just conclude your pi to pi star transition decreases with increasing the polarity of, okay, so the distance decreases. For this, therefore, the energy gap decreases and the wavelength increases. Like that, you can make a short note for you. And this is the practice question, like we have done for mesityl oxide. You can solve similarly for acetone, where they have mentioned different solvent and the wavelength. 279 nanometer in hexane, 272 in ethanol, you can see the slight decrease, and 264.5 in water. Further decrease means hypsochromic shift occurs for n to pi star transition, right? We have just now seen bathochromic shift for pi to pi. So they are talking about n to pi star transition, and you can explain why it is decreased. The same justification which you have already seen in the first question. So this you can solve it yourself. The next question is, you can see the solvent effect plays an important role, okay, where they are talking about the enones. The maximum solvent correction of water is given -8 and +11. Explain the following observation. So they have given you the dienone here, and with two data here, lambda max 295, epsilon, which tells you the intensity of the peak, 50 in the presence of hexane, which is a non-polar solvent, which again the next data, 255 nanometer, you can see that the wavelength is decreased here, right? Means blue shift or hypsochromic shift, and the intensity is increased in the presence of polar solvent. Here if you see, notice the polarity of the solvent increased here. As the polarity of the solvent increases, the hypsochromic shift you see for n to pi star transition. So we can assume that they are talking about n to pi star transition with increased intensity here. So we have to justify it. You can see here this dienone, which the first data is given in the presence of non-polar solvent. N to pi star, we can say, because N to pi star transition is forbidden transition, therefore the intensity is weak here. And the data, if the molar absorptivity value occurs between 10 to 100, we say that it is N to pi star transition, or it is a forbidden transition. So they are talking about, the data is given N to pi star transition. The next, you can see in the presence of ethanol, what happens because of the polarity, the keto-enol tautomerism will occur, and the keto will exist in the form of enol here. And why it is so? Because again, it is stabilized by hydrogen bonding in the presence of polar solvent, right? And now this is alpha-beta unsaturated ketone. You are having the oxochrome here. So basically, this increases the intensity here, okay, because you have the oxochrome here and you have the conjugation present here. So we know that as the conjugation here and oxochrome, the intensity will increase, but the wavelength is decreased here because we know the effect of solvent polarity. For n to pi star transition, the distance between n to pi increases, therefore the wavelength decreases. Okay, so basically the energy gap increases and so the wavelength decreases. So for wavelength, the reason is we have already seen why it is hypsochromic shift, because of the polarity of the solvent. And for the intensity, you can say intensity is increased because of the chromophore and oxochrome present here in this conformation, in this structure. The other data says that if you have slight basic medium here, the proton will be abstracted and you have a full negative charge here, which is readily available for the conjugation, right? So a small conjugation is present here, which increases the wavelength from 255 to 280. Okay, so it's a small bathochromic shift from 255 to 280. Intensity remains the same, as you have the same chromophore and oxochrome. So this is the basified ethanol. You can see that the detail, the justification which I told you just now, it is mentioned here in the terms of statements, and you have to present your answer in the same format. Okay, so very low intensity means N to pi star transition in the presence of ethanol hydrogen bonding. And for N to pi star, we know that the distance increases for N to pi, del E increases, therefore the wavelength increases. Okay, and in the presence of base, further this effect will be maximized, and you have a full negative charge, so greater electron availability is here, right? Greater electron availability means it requires less energy. Okay, so energy decreases, therefore the wavelength increases. So this is the justification why the wavelength increase, because the electrons are easily available for the electronic transition, so the energy required is less, therefore the wavelength is more. I hope you understood the concept of solvent polarity. This is a practice question. When para-nitrophenol is dissolved in water, the color is yellow. Okay, so nitro is here chromophore, benzene is chromophore, OH is oxochrome, right? So therefore you have here the one is electron withdrawing, other is electron donating. So extension of conjugation is present, therefore it is appearing in the visible region. But when it is basified, okay, in the presence of NaOH, the color deepens in intensity and that moves to the longer wavelength. So just now we have seen in the presence of basified solvent, what happens that in the presence of basified solvent, this the electron availability will be more, and so the energy required will be less and wavelength absorption will be more. So guys, this is the fact of solvent polarity. I hope you understood. You can solve more problems on this concept. Happy learning. See you in the next video. Bye.